See that? A bar that beans that you don't like, you'll be craving for it. When I was coming, I won't pack the Jebu Gary. It's pack better week. Waiting at talk. Hi there, welcome to my channel. My name is Jane and this is my YouTube where I share content about studying abroad, my PhD journey, my lifestyle and some motivation. If this is your first time of watching me, of seeing this face, please click the subscribe button to subscribe. But if this is not your first time, thank you so much for coming back. Someone sent me a message on my social media and he has already gotten admission to come study in the US. He sent me a message and he said, can you please make a video of the things that I need to know, the things I need to do before traveling to the US. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing tips with you guys, the things that you need to do, the things you need to know before moving abroad. So the first thing I'm going to be talking about is clothes. Now remember, the US Naira exchange rate is really high. So if you come here and you buy one shikini top, it's going to be really, really pricey when you compare it with the amount in Naira. So my advice to you would be, at least for that first semester, buy all the clothes that you need in Nigeria. Yes, there's nothing like, let me just pack one or two shirts. When I go to the US, I'll buy. When you come to the US and you pick up a shoe and it's $100 and you calculate $100 in Nigeria, you realize I don't have this much to be spending on clothes. So make sure you pack all the clothes that you need at least for the first semester. I don't know when you're going to be coming, when that is going to be, the winter period or the summer period. But for me personally, this is my personal opinion, you don't need to buy a coat in Nigeria. Of course, we have thick coat in Nigeria, but mind you, from my experience, they are not as good as what you need in the US, especially if you're going to a place where the winter is very extreme, like where I am. Just come with a good jacket that you can use, but when you come to the US, you can spend money and buy a very good coat and it will last you so long. And then for the ladies, my ladies, make sure you pack wigs. Make sure you pack wigs. Even if you don't used to wear wig in Nigeria, now that you're coming here, pack it. What did I say? Pack wig. Do you know why? If you watch my video, the one I made about living the US versus living Nigeria, I will touch it here. I talked about how it's very, very expensive, very, very pricey to make hair here in the US. And for the period that you just be coming, you'll be trying to settle down. If you're coming as a student, school already start, you have a lot of things to do. Trust me, you will not have time to be thinking of going to salon to make hair. And even if you go, you have time to go to the salon, how much the money you're going to spend for someone who is just coming, you use that money to do other things. So your best option is wigs. So please pack better wig. Waiting at talk. Pack better wig inside bag. Okay, let's move on. Then the next thing I'm going to talk about is food. Food is very important. It depends on where you're going to, right? Some cities like Texas, Maryland, you'll be able to find where to get African food, right? But it will be pricey. But your best bet is to make sure you pack as much food as you can before coming. You see all those guys that when you were school in Nigeria, used to be like me, I'm a big boy. I don't used to pack food when I'm going back to school. I just carry my backpack or my clothes and I'm out. See, if you're coming here, you need food, because if you don't, you're going to stay for months without eating Nigerian food. You see that eba, that beans that you don't like, you'll be craving for it. So my best bet for you is dry all your food, dry everything, pack as much as you can. And if you have money to pay for extra luggage, please pay for it and pack extra food. When I was coming, I won't pack the Jebu Gary. I will pack a Jebu Gary, stockfish, all those things. But there are certain things that you cannot come with. Something like anything that contains chicken in it, you cannot carry it. Like, you know, like our nut cubes, our Maggi Star. Though some people be like, you should grind it into powder, make it dry, and then pack it in something else, and they will allow you come in with it. Yeah, you can actually do that. You can peel out the nut from the pack, and then like from the wrap that shows it has chicken, and then put it in a bag or grind it, put it in a Ziploc and come with it. So make sure you pack enough food before coming. Then when you get down to the US, there are stores where you can actually buy cheap things. You know what we call okreka in Nigeria? This one, they are called thrift stores. thrift store. There's Old Navy, there's thrift stores. You can actually go there and get cheap things. You know, when you're just coming, right, you'll have a lot of things to do with money. So it might be a little bit tight for you, right? But there are actually places that you can go to and you get cheap things, like the thrift store. So at this point, my people, if you never subscribe, I mean, if you've not subscribed, please click the subscribe button to subscribe. If you've already subscribed, you don't need to do that again. Like I always say, if the subscribe button is gray in color, it says subscribe, you don't need to subscribe again. But if it is red, it means that my brother, my sister, you are yet to click the subscribe button. Come on, it's free. It's $0, $0.00, $0.00. Click the subscribe button and subscribe. The next thing is that before you travel, make sure you convert all of your naira to dollars. And not only convert it in dollars, make sure you have it in small bills. I didn't know this before I traveled. So the dollars that I came with were all in 100 bills. And I suffered for it. What do I mean by that? Imagine coming down here. I haven't settled down. I couldn't cook. I needed to eat. There was a pizza place close by. Glory be to God. Let me go get pizza. But on getting there, I gave them $100 for pizza of maybe $12 or so. And they were like, sorry, they can't give me change more than $50 or $20 that I have to go look for small bills. So please, when you're exchanging your dollars, don't just come with 100 bills. Just make sure you break it down to $1, $5, $10, $20. Also, because if you need to go from one place to the other, you need your $1 bill to pay the bus or whatever you're going to be using. So make sure you come with small bills. The next one is make sure you come with a good sneakers. Trust me, you will be needing it very, very well. Here in the US, you just cannot do without a good sneakers, whether it's summer or it's winter. So make sure you get a very good sneakers before coming. The next thing is that it will be very good for you to get in contact with someone who is from Nigeria in your school or in that city before coming. Because trust me, no man is an island, especially when you're moving to the US. You will need people to guide you. There are a lot of things that will be so difficult for you, but they will become easy if you have someone to direct you. Personally, what I did was, before coming, I didn't know anyone in my city or in the school. What I did was to go to my school Facebook and start scrolling through people that like the page to see if there'll be anyone that is a Nigerian. And luckily for me, I found one girl. Oh, I started messaging her on Facebook, and she was the one that came to pick me from the airport. So please try to get in contact with someone that is already there. Even if it will be better for you if it's a Nigerian or someone you can relate with, or maybe the graduate coordinator, tell them to help you get someone. Just make sure you have someone before coming. They will help you, they will guide you. So now when you come down, get a SIM card, try to get settled, ask questions. Anything that you do not understand, ask questions. Let people help you. People here are always willing to help, especially Nigerians. If you go and you meet Nigerians here, for some reason they're always like willing to help you. If you're just coming in to direct you, to guide you, so feel free, whatever you don't know, ask questions. For instance, when I got here, the money I pay for my internet is like less than what I would have been paid if I had just gone by myself to get an intern. But because I met someone who is a Nigerian and we talked, and she was guiding me, she helped me get a very cheap internet, which I wouldn't have gotten if it wasn't for her. And then for the academics, as a student, I want you to understand that the system of education here is different from that one in Nigeria. In Nigeria, getting an A is 70, right? Once you get 70, you get an A. But here in the US, an A is 93. 93 out of 100 is an A. So for you to get A, you have to get 93. And if you get 70, which gives you an A in Nigeria, 70 here is like a C or something like that. And trust me, you don't need a C. Getting a C here is like getting failure. You need an A or a B plus, A minus. So you need to take your studies seriously. And also, it's not like in Nigeria where you get to write maybe only one test and few assignments, or one or two assignments, and then at the end of the semester you take your exam. Here, for every course you're going to do a project. You write reports, you will do presentation, you will do assignments every week or bi-weekly depending on the professor, but most times every week you have an assignment for all your courses. I'm not even kidding. for all your courses, every week you have an assignment to submit, and then you have at least two exams you will do presentation for most likely for all your courses. So there's nothing like, I don't know how to talk in public, I cannot talk. My dear, you would have to talk. You just be calm, you got this, you can do it. Do your slides and go do your presentation, and don't worry about your accent. So some people come to the US and they try, immediately get to the US, they try to change their accent. You can never talk like an American immediately you get to the US. Fashion, that thing that people used to do. Okay, just be calm. If you watch my other video where I talked about the struggle of the accent, but it's fine, you're not the only one. You're never going to be the only one coming from a different country. So but just try to articulate your words very well so that they will hear you. You'll be fine. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe if you have, then subscribe again and keep the comments coming. And if I see another recommendation for video, I'll definitely make it, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Love you guys.